Okay, here we go. Alright. Hello. Good afternoon. How are you today? I am great, thank you. My name is Anthony, and I have been dabbling in the acrylic arts, so to speak, I guess you can say, doing some acrylic painting. I've seen a lot of YouTube videos, and it's just, it's caught my interest a lot, and I'm just fascinated by it, and just the way things go and how they manipulate and what you have in your head as an idea, and then when you put it down on a piece of canvas is something completely different. And you really, you can manipulate it to the best of your ability, and but what I found is that it just takes on a life of its own, which is really super cool. For example, like this piece right here, this is was an ode to Mardi Gras, and I wanted a very natural black canvas with just the standard colors of purple, white, and gold. And from what it was to what it is now was something completely different. When I first did this piece, it was a hot mess. I kid you not, it was a hot mess, and I just didn't like it. So I let it dry, and then I said, you know what, I'm just going to kind of redo it all over again. And so I used the same colors, but I did it with a different kind of formation, as you can see, like this S formation with a blowout. But what happened was it gave this really unique, cool texture to it on the second round. And I just now have completely fell in love with this. So, I mean, that's what I'm talking about. You know, what you have in your head is, you know, you have an idea of how it should be. And then as you start the process, it becomes something completely different. So, with that being said, I did this piece here. And yeah, it's good, it's nice, but it isn't what I wanted. And so instead of throwing this away and scrapping it, because this is all money, you know, so I'm just going to kind of just redo something else. And so I'm going to today do a swipe technique. And so I don't know, not swipe, but it's more of a drag kind of technique. I don't really know the technical term for it. But I'm just going to use some basic rainbow colors, Roy G. Biv, you know, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. And I'm going to take a white swipe, or whatever you use for the swipe, and I put in a couple drops of silicone, which is going to create a lot of cell action, you know? So when I swipe through all these colors, the cells are going to integrate with all the, you know, the rainbow colors itself. And we're gonna kind of see what happens. So that's the thought process in my head anyways. So this is the first time I've posted on Facebook a few times, just kind of doing some things that are, you know, listed behind me or shown behind me. But now this is the first time I'm actually gonna use my YouTube channel to really showcase, you know, kind of what I'm doing here. So I have my little studio, and I got some great mood music playing. Now the colors that I've used is these are NYX Pro. I got them on Amazon. They came in a case of, they're 8.4 fluid ounces or 8.5 ounces in this. It came in a case of 16, I believe, all different colors. So this color, the red, I had to enhance it a little bit because it came out when I mixed it with the medium. came out pinkish. And so I didn't want it pink. I wanted it a little darker. But again, I'm still kind of hoping that it's going to dry a little darker. But anyways, I added some magenta to it, which is from Deco Art. So I added some magenta to it to darken it up. I'm also got, again, with the same company, Nick Pro, there's Phthalo Blue. I have a Spring Green. There is a beautiful lemon color. Also, I got orange. I have a beautiful violet. And then I've also added this color shift from Folk Art. This is a metallic. So I created, so I added some of this. So basically all of the paints are like a 1-to-3 ratio. So it's one part paint, so about an ounce of paint, to 3 ounces of Floetrol. And you can get different types of Floetrol. There's an Australian one, but this is what I found on Amazon. So this is a nice mixing medium for your paints. Some people like to utilize the putting water in there. I did not. I wanted these thick. And the reason why I say that is because the white that I'm using is very thin, and it has the silicone in there, so it's going to interact with that. So again, let's see how it goes. So as always, because I'm a mess and I get things everywhere, I'm messy, so messy. Get some cards out here. Now, take a little sip of some juice. Perfect. Now, for me, it's easier to work backwards instead of working forward. So I'm going to take all my colors and I'm going to align them this way, and this way, and this way, and this way, and this way. And then I'm going to take my swipe that I'm going to use to manipulate the white color. I'm going to use this kind of plexiglass, and I'm just going to kind of drag it down and swipe through it. I guess, I don't know if swiping is the right, maybe dragging is the right technique. I don't know if this is too thick of a piece of plastic, this plexiglass, to use, but it seems pretty flexible. I've seen it used with tissue paper. I've seen it used with, you know, just regular towel paper, paper towels, plastic, you know, piece of saran wrap to drag it through. So I'm just going to use what I have in my studio here, and we're going to kind of go from there. So again, first up is the red, or this deep pink. I'm just hoping that it's going to dry a little darker. So let me put that stick there. And we have that one there. Now I may put these on a little thicker just to eat up space. Yeah, that's what I think I'm gonna do. So there's the red, and then we go with the yellow. I'm gonna give that just another stir here. Put that in my handy dandy tray. Yeah, this paint's pretty thick. Maybe you should have added a little bit of water just in case. But you know what? The thing is about with this, it's all experimenting. And we'll see how that goes. Now my Floetrol sat for a little while, and it created a skin. So even though I shook up the Floetrol, some of the skin came through. So I haven't figured out how to yet strain it yet by this, but we'll see how that goes. See, there's a little bit of a, what do you call it, skin in here too. So get that rid of. Okay, that. Let's use the orange. Saw a little piece of skin come through, so I'm gonna use this to kind of pick it up and get rid of it. You know what's really cool though is the tools that you can utilize to create this art is kind of endless, because you can like I've been collecting just these cups that I can use to make paints with. So, you know, I have to store them, and so that way I can keep them fresh instead of, you know, dumping them out and wasting a lot of money. So whatever you utilize, but look, here's a little Alfredo sauce tin. Just wash it out, threw it in the dishwasher. Now I can use that to mix paints with. All right, so red, orange, red, yellow, orange, orangey, green. Green. I'm gonna do some blue. This is such a pretty blue. I'm just in love with this blue. Now the music I have in the background, I don't know if it's picking it up or not, but it's just the Smooth Jazz channel from YouTube. I like listening to it. It's really pretty. And now we got the violet. Now, I don't know if I'm going to go all the way up on my canvas because, again, this is going to spread out when I use the plexiglass to drag through. So we're just going to do that. I thought about putting some black in there, but not really kind of feeling it, so I'm just going to kind of leave it as is. So let me move my paints out of the way. Let me get this. Okay. Now, this white is pretty potent. Generally you only use like a drop or two drops at most silicone. I think I got a little crazy with it. So, we'll see. But, since it has some extra drops of silicone in there, it's really going to create a unique effect. So, now, my other thought is, do I want to do like a small swipe of white or a small piece of white in between? I don't know. But you know what? It's interesting. So here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna just kind of drag it along a little bit. I don't want to say drag, but I'm just gonna kind of stretch it out. There we go. Yeah, we're gonna stretch that out. That looks better. And now we can take our yellows. Fill this in. And then I can take my blue. Give a little bit more there. And my violet. So I'm also looking at my my canvas here. There's some air bubbles, but there's also some pieces of that I need to get out of here, because I just feel like it's going to be a mess if I drag that all the way through. So there you go. So let me get these out of here real quick. I guess that latex maybe sat a little bit longer than I anticipated. So, do that. Now, in order to use this to get rid of any air bubbles that might be in my canvas, and then let me use a little bit more red here. And then a little bit more white on the corner here. All right, so now, moment of truth, I take it. Let's see what happens here. So again, I'm gonna use my film. And I'm going to take it and I'm going to drag it all the way through. Now, it doesn't fit the whole canvas, so I'm going to have to do it, you know, in another section, but no worries. So, let's do this. Whee! Okay, let's try this section here. Yeah, that didn't work out too well. So let me try this again. All right, so now let's take this, kind of stretch it out. Mm-hmm. All right, now we're gonna stretch it this way. This is kind of interesting. I'm liking it, but I just feel like it's missing something here. I wonder, and this is the fun thing about this, I like it, but I'm not in love with it just yet. Let me do this. It's pretty cool. It's actually pretty cool. Something's got me kind of wanting to like really twist this and be like super weird about it. My thought is, okay, here's my thought. I'm going to take my, First of all, let me use my heating gun here. Again, I'm still popping all the air bubbles, and this heat from the gun will also increase the cell activator on this. So maybe that was a little too much, but it's okay. I have a thought. I don't know how well this is gonna work out. But what if I take, this is so unconventional. But here's the really cool thing. I got nothing to lose. Oh, pretty. Oh, this is so nice. Oh, yeah. Who's your daddy? Oh, yeah, this is good stuff. This is nice. So I'm taking my hair dryer here. And I'm just blowing upwards into it. And it's giving me these fantastic colors that is just off the wall, crazy cool. This is really neat. Oh, wow, am I giddy. I am so super, super giddy right now. You have no idea. This is really super cool. So interesting. Oh, wow. This is fantastic. Here's what I need to do real quick. I need to take just a little bit of this right here on the corner. I need to take a little bit of this violet here. Hold on. Just on the corner. That one's fine, that one's fine. I'm gonna put a little bit of red over on this edge here. Okay, all right. Okay, this is cool. No! Oh. Seriously? Well, that's the price you pay. So, hold on, but it's fixable. That's the cool thing. Just a little bit of white drop here. Drop there. Drop there. Drop there. Okay. Now, I'm going to take this, since I got some paint on it. We'll do that. Get that. Now we'll fix this little blob. And this is so much fun, so much fun, because we're going to touch up this, and we're going to touch up that, little bit of touch up here, little bit of touch up there. Yo, telling you, this is super cool. Check this out. So, do this. Okay, so super cool. I am super, super stunned with this. Oh man, where did that come from? I got a blob of white that just came out of nowhere. Yay! Okay, not gonna mess with it anymore, but I want you to see it. Whee! Super cool. So, I'm gonna put this back down. I'm gonna get my camera. I'm gonna bring you guys in for a little quick view of that. This. I thought I had a. Oh, yeah. Oh, here it is. Okay. So, I'm going to grab my camera and I'm going to give you a little close up view of it. So, bear with me here. And then. Okay. So, let me swip you around here. Okay, so this is the overall result of my picture, my acrylic art. So this was using the primary colors of the rainbow. We did a drag technique that with the white that had the silicone in it to give us some cells action. Didn't really care for how that turned out, so I used my blow dryer and I blew up into it to create this really cool kind of like magical abyss kind of thing. So this is just going to sit here and dry. And let me put you back here. Oops. So, super cool, super nice. I'm digging it. I'm a little crock-eyed over here, but that's okay. You can at least see this. Again, I'm going to post this on YouTube. I'll post it to Facebook. We'll see what happens. Again, for those of you who want to take a better look, this is my picture, my painting that I created. and I'm super, super happy with this. So it'll go up on that wall a little bit later. It'll be dried, and I'm gonna put some varnish on it to keep it nice and pretty, and we are good to go. So I'm not gonna mess with it anymore. I promise. I'm done. And let me turn around my little cuppy cup. Very good. All right, y'all. That is it for me. Sorry, I know I messed up on this angle here. So that's it for me. Be good, be safe. I'm working on developing my website. It's gonna be Super Art Bear or Anthony James Art, one of the two. Maybe even a combination of two, because I am generally known as Super Bear. Here's my little Superman tattoo, see? So I am Super Bear, but my name is Anthony James, and this is my studio for acrylic art. And thank you so much for joining me. If you have any questions, please feel free to send me a message through my Facebook page or my YouTube channel page. And I'll be more than happy to answer what I know from what I've been learning thus far from all the other wonderful, talented artists out there. And so thank you all very much for keeping me inspired to just be creative and to have a nice outlet just to kind of do some therapeutic painting here. And I hope that you all join me for some more episodes. So thank you all. Oops. Thank you all very much. Appreciate it. And have a good night or good afternoon. Bye.